In the history of mankind, there have been several buildings that have eclipsed everything that has gone before and set new standards forever. But there have also been numerous completely overambitious projects that have turned out to be total flops in retrospect. In this video, we would like to present 8 of these mega projects, which were not only incredibly expensive, but above all, extremely unnecessary. We'll show you airports that were never used, roller coasters that cost millions and turned into complete disasters, and even completely new cities that no one will ever live in. So, it's gonna be extremely exciting. So, stay tuned here at Wonderlane. Oh, and write us in the comments which building in the world you find particularly beautiful or ingenious. We are curious. For number 8, we travel directly to the other end of the world and show you a building with which a particularly controversial country once wanted to advance to the top of the world, namely North Korea. While the totalitarian-ruled country hasn't exactly covered itself in glory in recent years, and it's virtually impossible to travel there, especially for tourists, the state tried to open its doors in 1987 and present itself as progressive and tolerant, especially to the West. To achieve this goal, the government of Kim Il-sung, the grandfather of the current ruler Kim Jong-un, planned a mega project that was unparalleled at the time. North Korea wanted to build one of the largest hotels in the world. This hotel, named Ryugyong Hotel, was to be 330 meters high, have 105 floors, and provide space for 3,000 rooms. Moreover, it was designed in the shape of a pyramid, so that it could be seen from several kilometers away. So, starting from 1987, numerous architects started the construction until 5 years later, the disaster happened. In 1992, the construction work was stopped out of nowhere, and in the heart of North Korea's capital, Pyongyang, suddenly stood a completely empty skyscraper, of which only the concrete shell was completed. It took a whole 16 years until the construction could be continued, but then everything was already in vain. Due to further sanctions and political isolation, North Korea isolated itself further and further from the rest of the world and never became the tourism hotspot it had dreamed of back then. Although the hotel is now finished, it is unclear whether it will be used at all, as many North Koreans cannot afford to spend a night in a hotel. Next, we come to Europe, more precisely to Spain, and thus to one of the most expensive and at the same time most pointless mega projects of all time. Since Spain is one of the most popular vacation destinations in the world, and accordingly, millions of visitors come to the country every year, the airport in the capital of Madrid has a problem, and that is that it is hopelessly overloaded. For this reason, numerous authorities and investors decided a few years ago to look for a solution to finally relieve the Madrid airport. So, they didn't just want to build another airport. They wanted to create a new hub for international air traffic in the middle of Spain. The new Ciudad Real Central Airport, which cost over $1.3 billion to build, was not built in Madrid, but 200 kilometers further south in the middle of the Spanish wasteland. When, in addition, the construction completely went bankrupt shortly before the planned opening in 2012, it was clear to many that not only had an extremely large amount of money been buried here, but from now on, there would also be a completely unnecessary airport in the middle of nowhere. Although the airport was opened as planned in 2012, every major airline refused to include the new airport in its routes. Since the Ciudad Real Central Airport is located extremely far away from Madrid, no one made any signs to take the long way just to fly from there. Since then, all tourists still travel via Madrid, and even though the airport there is still totally congested, it is still a much better option than the Ciudad Real Central Airport, which is still hardly used today. On number 6, we continue with a mega project in the middle of Germany that caused a worldwide sensation for exactly 4 days in 2013, and has since been seen as a successful example of a major mismanagement. In 2009, the Nürburgring began building what was then the world's fastest roller coaster, the Ring Racer. With a speed of over 200 kilometers an hour, the operators of the Nürburgring wanted to attract new visitors to the region and thus set a world record that had never been seen before. However, nothing came of this plan. In the next 4 years, the opening of the Ring Racer had to be postponed again and again due to either complicated construction errors or financial bottlenecks. When the roller coaster was finally able to open in 2013, however, it was nothing more than a laughingstock for many. Instead of the promised 200 kilometers an hour, it now only ran at 160 kilometers an hour, and due to the insolvency of the Nürburgring operator at the time, it had to close again just 4 days after opening. Since then, the Ring Racer has stood at the Nürburgring without any use, and has become a symbol of how great plans can fail fatally. Let's continue with a building that was never built, but still cost an incredible 70 million euros. We're talking about the London Garden Bridge. In 2012, several architects in collaboration with the City of London presented a planned structure that was to revolutionize the world of architecture. They wanted to build a 300 meter long bridge over the River Thames, which was not only intended for pedestrians, but was also to be completely planted with trees and flowers. With this 100% sustainable bridge, the city wanted not only to give itself a greener image, but above all, to attract over 3 million visitors a year. However, this never came to pass. In 2015, it turned out that the project would cost more than twice as much as originally planned. In addition, many Londoners questioned the sense of such a bridge, as it was to be in an area where there were already 4 other bridges. After numerous public discussions, the city decided not to build the London Garden Bridge after all. At this point, however, over 70 million euros had already been spent on planning and development, without even 1 meter of the bridge having been built. The numerous investors never saw this money again. For number 4, we're going to Hawaii, an American state known for its breathtaking landscapes. What many people don't know, however, is that there is a structure in Hawaii that is seen by many not only as extremely unnecessary, but above all as a totally bad political idea. Across Hawaii runs Interstate H3, a 26 kilometer long highway that guarantees one of the most spectacular views in the world. However, the view and the route through the mountains is for many the only positive thing about this highway. Among other things, the route was to run through the territory of a native Hawaiian tribe. In addition, environmentalists saw numerous violations of various environmental laws prior to construction, which is why the engineers and architects had to get extremely creative during construction. To comply with all environmental regulations and not inconvenience any Aboriginal tribe, numerous large curves and swerves had to be incorporated into the architecture. When the highway finally opened in 1997, many were shocked by the result. Thus, for many, it was not only a scandal that Interstate H3 opened 37 years late, but also that its route was completely useless. Indeed, the highway does not connect any major cities in Hawaii, and, moreover, cost 5 times as much as originally planned. The highway is occasionally used by a few cars, but considering that it cost 1.3 billion euros and does not connect any relevant places, one can confidently say that this project was not necessary. Number 3. We come to an extremely complicated issue that has posed gigantic challenges to humanity for decades. And that is the question of how to safely store the waste produced by nuclear power plants in the process of generating electricity without harming people and the environment. While much of the world's nuclear waste is often stored above ground near nuclear power plants, nearly all scientists agree that it would make much more sense to store nuclear waste underground. For this reason, some US agencies decided in 1987 to stow much of their nuclear waste deep below the Earth's surface in the Yucca Mountains. However, even the planning of this project led to some problems. There are more than than 100 nuclear power plants in the US, but none of them are located in Nevada, the state where all the waste was to be stored. Since the residents of Nevada did not want their state to become a nationwide nuclear waste dump, there were numerous protests and legal proceedings. Although the construction of the repository was officially approved a short time later, this only further fueled the protest. In 2010, the project was finally stopped by Barack Obama and his administration. At that time, however, over $17 billion had already been invested in planning and construction, which ultimately turned out to be completely pointless. Before we get to number one, and thus a project that can hardly be surpassed in terms of unnecessity, we have one more honorable mention that should not be missed. We are talking about the airport in Berlin. For many, it was an absolute miracle when the Berlin-Brandenburg Airport actually opened at the end of 2020, 9 years behind schedule. After more than 14 years of construction, dozens of mishaps, and above all, costs of more than 7 billion euros, most had already given up on the new airport. And although it is now operating successfully, and will probably become one of Europe's most important hubs in the future, for many, it still symbolizes poor management of a project that still has numerous critics today. On number one, we now come to a project that not only assumed unimaginable proportions, but also turned out to be an absolute mistake. It's about the city of Naypyidaw, a place with which Malaysia wanted to take a big step into the future. In 2002, in a top secret operation, the then Myanmar military government began building a new city from scratch. The city was named Naypyidaw, and was to be presented to the world a few years later as the new capital of Myanmar. To this day, the reason for this change of capital is unclear to many, but it is speculated that this move may have had military reasons. In the following years, everything was built in Naypyidaw that is known from the largest cities in the world. Gigantic highways with 10 lanes, huge golf courses, and over 100 luxury hotels to attract rich tourists from all over the world. So, all in all, Naypyidaw has numerous things that make a city interesting, except for one, and that is inhabitants. Because, although Myanmar's new capital has room for several million people, just a few hundred thousand live in the area. In addition, most of the inhabitants do not live in the city itself, but in rundown suburbs, because they cannot afford to live in Naypyidaw. In addition, important components such as a good healthcare system, educational facilities, or economic options were also completely forgotten when the capital was planned. In the end, most people stayed in the previous capital, Yangon, which led to Naypyidaw becoming a kind of ghost town where you rarely see people on the gigantic streets. And that's it for our video, and 8 unnecessary mega projects that really went beyond any scope. Write us in the comments which project you found particularly crass, and if you know of any other such projects. Otherwise, like this video if you enjoyed it, subscribe to Wonderlane for more cool content, and we'll see you next time, here at Wonderlane.